Save me, God, for the waters are up to my neck, sinking mud.
I have become a stranger to my kindred, an alien to my mother's children. It is zeal for your house that has consumed me. The insults of those who insult you have fallen on me. Insults have broken my heart, so that I am in despair. I looked for pity, but there was none, and for comforters, but I found none. They gave me poison for food, and for my thirst they gave me vinegar to drink. I will praise the name of God with a song. I will magnify him with thanksgiving. The Lord hears the needy and does not despise his own that are in bonds.
I am weary, and my eyes grow dim. Save me, God, in the way.
In The Problem of Pain, C.S. Lewis famously said, "Pain insists upon being attended to. God whispers to us in our pleasures, speaks in our conscience, but shouts in our pains. It is his megaphone to rouse a deaf world." Today's prophetic psalm beckons to us when we're in pain. After Jesus rose from the dead, the writer of Hebrews encouraged us with these words: "We have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, one who is able to sympathize with our weaknesses, one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. When we are heartbroken, remember Jesus, whose heart was broken and devastated by insults to the point of despair. When we are left without pity, sympathy, consolation, or comfort, remember Jesus, who was utterly abandoned and alone in his time of greatest need. When we are misunderstood, rejected, humiliated, betrayed, or falsely accused, remember Jesus, who experienced all of these. Jesus fully understands and enters into our pain with us. In remembering Jesus, we respond to the invitation to confidently approach God's throne of grace. Picture a beloved child who is worn out from their play and exploration, knees grazed, tummy empty, ready for a cuddle, reaching their arms up to the one they know will embrace them and give them everything they need. That's the kind of confidence we get to have with God, who lavishes upon us mercy and grace and everything else we need. Remember Jesus.
Zeal for your house has consumed me. Zeal for your house has consumed me.
Lord God, whose blessed Son, our Savior, gave his body to be whipped and his face to be spit upon, give me the grace to accept joyfully the sufferings of the present time, confident of the glory that shall be revealed. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, my Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, for by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
As for Amen. Me, I am poor and in pain. Save me, God, by your salvation.